Welcome to another episode of Go Fish BC on Shaw TV. Today we're on Stump Lake, halfway between Merritt and Kamloops, right along Highway 5A. And my guest, Savas, has got a hot one on right now. So we're going to land this fish, right, Savas?
Hopefully. No pressure on now with the camera rolling.
So we got a beautiful, flat, calm morning. It's mid-September, and it's going to get hot today.
For some reason, they always want to go to that anchor rope.
Yeah, I know. They know where it is. Oh, there we go. Beautiful fish. There's a lot of food in Stump Lake, and these are well-conditioned fish.
You can see the girth on them.
They pull pretty good, don't they?
Oh, they do. When you think you can turn their head.
Oh, yeah.
There he is.
That's a beautiful black water. Straight a rainbow. Well done.
Yes. Thank you for netting.
Oh, I'll let you do the honors. I think once you get the hook out, those
stumps,
I'm going to pump them.
Okay.
Have a quick look at what he's eating.
Oh, it's out already. Nice thing about barbless hooks.
You want to pump them?
No, you can go ahead. I'll let you.
Oh, he's got something in him.
That's a nice fish, about 17, 18 inches.
Yeah, so I'll let you do the honors and let him go. And just hold him out for the camera, if you can, out the side. So that's a blackwater strainer rainbow that's has been stocked into Stump for a number of years. And probably will be 3 years old next spring. It's a beautiful fish. And we'll let him go. Oh yeah,
perfect. Love when they take off like that. You can see them slowly swim away.
Yeah. So Stump Lake actually has a real interesting history. It was rehabilitated, chemically treated in the early 1960s to remove a number of different non-game fish species, and then subsequently restocked with the rainbow trout. And in about 1966-67, Field and Stream rated Stump Lake as one of the top 10 lake fisheries in North America. That's how good the fishing was, Savas. It was an incredible fishery. And then it's gone through some changes with fluctuating water levels. And during the 70s, the water table really dropped and the pH came up. It got very alkaline. And then the water levels came up in the mid-80s to early 90s, and we had fantastic fishing because the pH went down. And now we're on a bit of we went down on a downside again where the pH started to go up, to go up again. And it all fluctuates with water levels, the logging that's been done in the watershed, and the groundwater levels. But we're on a bit of an upswing now, and hopefully the lake is going to continue to produce. It's also stocked with kokanee, and
you can see the quality of the fish.
Oh yeah, they're just chunks, so
beautiful. And not that was an awfully long fish, but it's very thick.
Oh yeah,
it had a lot of power in it too.
Oh, they pull, so
that was nice.
Get our lines back out there and see if we can catch another one.
Sounds good.
So Savas, that fish you caught was feeding, even though you caught it on a leech. It is early in the morning, and what's in them?
It's full of chronomids and one damsel.
Yeah. So what would you put on? Because there's some chromy-looking ones in there.
I'd put a smaller chronomid on, probably a size 14 or 16 chronomid.
Yeah.
Almost in a static bag or a chromy style. Like a little chromy like this would be perfect. Little white tuff on the top.
Okay, yeah. So we're just going to hold them up there. So that's kind of what we're going to use to imitate those chronomids that are in there. So we're anchored in 18 feet of water, and there's a few fish jumping around the boat, and that's key when fishing this lake, is you got to find the fish that are moving and feeding, and that's why we move, for that one fish to jump.
And they're moving all around us, which is a good sign.
It's a good sign. So Stump Lake, you know, it can be a wonderful fishery. It is a wonderful fishery right along a major highway, but they can be moody. And You got to try to solve the puzzle, and that's why it's called fishing.
Yeah. They're feeding on chronomids and we're using leeches.
Yeah. Oh, I think we might switch now.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So, Savas, I see another fish rolled over there. I'm going to get Fred to pull the anchor. We're going to go chase that fish. We'll be right back. So Savas, you live in Kelowna?
Yes, I do.
So what are some good lakes to fish in around the Kelowna area? And then what about an example of a trophy lake and then a beginner's lake?
Yeah, one of the better lakes around the Kelowna area for a little bit larger fish is Half Hume Lake. It's a great lake, great hatches in June, July, and gets good again in the fall. You can fish the shallows in October. But Penask Lake, if someone hasn't fished before or caught a fish on a fly rod, it's a great lake. It's an artificial fly-only lake and rough road in, but it's worth the journey into it.
Oh yeah, it's like you're going to catch a lot of fish.
There is. It's a place where you're almost guaranteed fish.
And then you've got basically an urban lake in Shannon Lake.
Yeah, great lake that's got some large rainbow trout in there, and it also has bass and perch too, so it's a great community lake.
Great. So lots of opportunities in and around the Kelowna area.
Oh, there is. Within an hour, there's quite a few lakes to choose from.
Perfect. So we've met up with Steve Miracle from the Provincial Fisheries Program on Stump today as well. And he's doing, with his son Jake, are doing a test net just to see the condition of the kokanee. So, Steve, what have you got there?
Well, we've got a mature kokanee, Brian. We've stocked this lake with two-end kokanee.
So diploid, so they're reproductive.
They're reproductive. And yeah, they'll come here. The creek of the mouth is, or the mouth of the creek is right behind us here. And they're just milling around looking for a place to spawn.
Right. So how's the pH in the lake been lately?
Well, the pH up to 4 years ago, already 10 years ago, the pH went above 9. And these fish were virtually non-existent, as were the rainbows. The lake really crashed. But since we've had three very wet years, and we've seen the lake probably come up a meter and a half, 2 meters. And as a result, the pH has dropped. We're below 9 now, we're about 8.8. And as expected, we're starting to see these fish come back.
Yeah, so if we get another great winter, Lots of snow. We're going to have a phenomenal fishery out here next year.
Absolutely. No, it's starting to come back. It's good to see. You know, we do know it's probably a blip, and we'll see that drought conditions come back, but it's sure nice to have the reprieve and get some of these fish in.
Well, we'll let you get back to work because we've got to go and catch a fish now.
Okay. Sounds good.
Thanks, Steve.
You bet.
Even though we had a tough day today, Savas, it is fall, and we've had actually some freezing weather out, so a lot of guys are going to be asking you what to do. How do you fish in the fall? What do you suggest?
Yeah, as we start to fish into cooler weather, start fishing back into the shallows using indicators with chronomids or scuds or even leeches, and just work them. Also, dragonfly nymphs in smaller sizes start to work well, too.
And the key is, like you said, it's as the water cools, those fish move into shallower and shallower water.
They do. Right now it was a little bit warm today, so they were still a little bit deeper, but as it starts to cool off, they're right into the shallows. Brian, what's new with the Freshwater Fish Society?
Well, we've had another interesting year on the water, actually, Savas. We surpassed another 25,000 participants in Learn to Fish programs, so that's a lot of programs that Learn to Fish was delivered in both Kelowna in Kamloops area, Prince George, certainly the Lower Mainland and Southern Vancouver Island. And we continue to work on the website, upgrading the website to provide more information to anglers on how to fish, where to fish, contour maps of lakes, and up to the minute, actually, stocking records. So there's a lot of information that you can get off the website, gofishbc.com. Well, Savas, we're gonna head off the water because we're baked. And it was great to have you. I appreciate you coming over from Kelowna and doing this episode with us. And I know we'll catch up to you on the water somewhere when it's a little bit cooler.
Well, thank you, Brian. That was a great day, even though we only got the one fish.
It's always be up. That's why we call it fishing. It's always great to be on the water. So stay tuned. We've got another episode to shoot somewhere in southern British Columbia. And so stay tuned to your TV. Watch for us, Go Fish BC on Shaw TV.